Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Dads and Six Podcast, episode number 20. I'm one of your hosts.
No one will know what just happened there because I cut right after that.
Say the thing, episode number 20. That's 19 more than I thought we'd do.
Yeah, you've done it for 20 episodes so far, 19.
I didn't do it last week.
Yeah, I know.
You made a comment though, didn't you?
Bring it back.
Something about drinking age.
I did. 20 is that awkward thing where it's like 19 is old enough to drink. 21's cool in the States. Like now you can go to the States and stuff and have a good time.
So 20 is awkward.
20 is just that, I guess you're in your 20s.
So this is the awkward child episode.
This is the awkward child episode. Nicholas Mazzeo, 2012 Soldier of the Year, Jesus Castillo, and the best man, Jamie Campbell.
Howdy.
Can't forget Nicholas Mazzeo, the Night Mongoose, though.
No, that was just in episode 18.
God, like he's literally in the group chat where we discuss.
He's not present.
Oh my God.
He's never
one
present.
Of these days, I'm going to do my own like spinoff where I'm going to just talk to you about how retarded these guys are. You should see the amount of texts that go on. It just.
You think the show makes itself?
Hours of just scrolling them two just chatting about.
Making the show
lightsabers.
Better.
Oh my God. Anyways, gentlemen, how are you?
I'm salty now.
Pretty good. It's good to see you guys again.
It's been a while.
It's been too long.
Glad to have you back here for another week in exciting adventures on the Dads and Six podcast.
Yep.
Anyways, let's jump into the drink of the show here because we got a little concoction here. We are going to drink yerba mate. Yerba. How do you Argentine?
Mate.
Yerba mate.
Yerba mate.
Just mate, man. Just say mate.
Mate. This is a predominantly... I don't think they drink it anywhere outside of South America unless you bring it. But I think there's a South American
drink.
Uruguay and Argentina predominantly.
Brazil drinks it too.
Brazil,
like parts of it.
Paraguay.
Yeah.
So.
Let me walk you through it.
This is our first non-alcoholic drink.
Pardon?
This is our first non-alcoholic drink.
Yeah, we broke that streak of two.
Yeah. So what this is nothing crazy.
No, it's just tea.
All right.
It's just tea. It's just tea.
Can you talk while you're preparing it?
Yeah, so this is...
Or do you want me to talk while you prepare it?
I was going to say what... Okay, well, fuck you. I'm just going to start. So I was going to say, this is my mom's like legit set. Like, this is what she uses every day. So my
recipe?
Mom drinks this every single... She's sick, she's happy, she's mad, she's sad.
If you're a good Uruguayan Argentinian...
Every day.
This is a breakfast drink, a lunch drink, a dinner drink.
Yeah.
This is guests come over drink.
That's a hefty spoonful.
Okay, Ray, watch this.
Watch the other 18. So this is obviously loose leaf tea, I guess.
Yes.
Right? It's not...
Oh, we should have started with this.
With the gourd?
This is...
Or the bombilla.
Bombilla. So this actual cup
is... Show and tell.
This actual cup is called the mate. Yeah. So this actually is called the mate.
It's a living thing.
Yeah.
Mate. It was.
This straw is basically a straw with a little filter. It's a weird kind of filtery thing. It's called a bombilla. Okay.
I think it's just Spanish for straw.
Yeah. It's a straw, but it's a straw with a filter basically at the bottom.
Filters out all the
things. And you put it in there. You put yerba mate into the mate.
Yerba is becoming more popular in like Western.
Oh,
like
yeah.
It's like more
those,
people are recognized.
Those Sobe
drinks.
Sobe drinks,
mate.
Yeah. All have yerba mate.
There's a lot of good health benefits, which I don't know of. But if you guys follow the soccer world.
So last night, actually, saw the premiere of a new show from the History Channel called Six. It's about these three dads. no joke. It's called Six. And similar to us, it's about the Navy SEALs, Team Six.
Yeah.
Right? It's a History Channel. It's a thing, but, and one of the guys...
There was a fake army joke in there somewhere, but I can't find it.
Yeah. One of the Navy SEALs, right? It's not a documentary. It's actually like a TV show. But anyways, he's a Spanish guy, and he goes around drinking mate wherever he goes. Mm-hmm. Also, Messi and Luis Suarez drink mate all the time.
Yeah, if you follow soccer, you'll know who the Uruguayan or Argentinian is because they're carrying on a mate. But
okay, that's good.
It's unnecessarily
so,
full.
No,
that's exactly.
That's exactly. No, he just makes this up.
like you have any idea what's going on. So now it comes the big difference here. Uruguayans would just pour hot water onto this and then drink it.
Called an amargo, it's just bitter.
Bitter, no sugars.
You know, like that.
No,
milk, no sugar in your tea.
The Argentinian way is just a little bit of sugar.
Bastardize it.
So just on top. Like, literally, there's no stirring it, just on top. That might be too much. I don't know.
It's perfect.
My Mata skills probably need a little work. My mom's probably really mad at me, but that's it. That's all it is.
And there is a little step sometimes. I don't think my dad does it, but like you could put a little cool water in there to like it like settles the sherba and all that and stuff. But whoa. Yeah.
So there's all the sugar.
There's put a little bit more sugar. So as you know, you guys are wondering, wait, why is there only one? That is literally the whole point of mate, is it's a share drink.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like if
hot water.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know, if you're passing around a cigarette or a joint, you just share the one, right? Yeah. This is the same idea.
Who's smoking joints?
No, I'm just saying, like, you know. But the idea is you pass this along. Technically, the person who finishes the water in it is supposed to refill it before passing it on. Mm-mm. So
or sometimes there's a desert, like today.
Oh, true.
There's a designated person who's gonna serve mate, and that's it. Another little tradition that I know my family does is you don't say, so when you drink it, when it's empty, you hand it back to me. You don't say thank you. You don't say anything. When you're done, like when you don't want any more, you hand it back and say gracias. And that's my cue. You say gracias, you're done. You no longer want mate. I don't know if that's a hard and fast rule.
It just sounds like a courtesy thing to do.
But on the last one, because you could drink mate for an hour.
Like, yeah, the whole, like, we will be sipping on this the entirety of the show, most likely.
My family will get together in like 2-3 hours and sit there and drink mate. It's like, fill this pot 6 times. Anyways, I'm going to have the first one.
And I think the other courtesy thing.
Like you kill all that right now?
Yeah.
Just poured like what?
Not that much water.
Oh, okay.
It's kind of like a gulp or two.
You take a toke.
No.
No, it's not a lot in there. It's, yeah, maybe 2 or 3 gulps.
Might be.
Yeah.
You sip it. And also, I guess an etiquette rule is to not slurp it. Like when you're done, like to make that slurping noise, I think is.
So yeah. So there's a whole bunch of traditions. It depends if you're doing it with like, yeah, your mom, your dad, and your brother. It's one thing. If you're doing it in a big group, right? Because it's the same rules. But if you're doing a big group, sometimes the person serving would have a little napkin, and just wipe the tip of the bombilla, the straw, and that's it.
Is there caffeine in this?
Shitload of caffeine.
Yeah. Like any tea. Like any loose leaf tea. It has caffeine. Apparently has tons of antioxidants and all that good stuff. It's like a super tea type thing.
And you finished that already?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I mean, there's a tiny... I could really suck
it's going to settle. Like, because I just poured it in. It's going to settle eventually. And you just pour more water.
So one day we'll do my native culture's drink, Coca-Cola.
I thought you were saying like Labatt Blue.
Speaking of your native... country or place. I was originally looking to do a road trip
to Canada.
Yeah.
Or to like England.
No, I'm talking about Canada. I was looking to go to Newfoundland.
I've been twice on a drive and three or four times on a plane.
I can't fathom. Like, I've done road trips to Dallas. We went to Dallas one time. I've driven to Florida. I've driven like tons of times. Like, I do lots of good road trips. Insane to Newfoundland. So first of all, you have to drive from here to North Sydney, Nova Scotia.
Yeah.
Okay? It's a 20-hour drive. Mm-hmm. No problem. I can do that. Get to North Sydney, Nova Scotia. You have to get on a ferry that is from 6 to 7 hours.
I don't call it a ferry.
It's a boat, giant boat.
It's a huge, like, yeah. It's a huge.
So I think that the term is ferry because it ferries you.
And it ferries your car.
So the one I went on was called the Caribou, and it was massive.
Yeah, they're huge.
And it
huge.
Had a whole thing, like, so it's like.
That's the name of the
we
boat.
Got on at like let's say 8 p.m. And there's a whole, like, there's a band in there. Yeah. There's video games. There's like a whole thing. You can get a cabin to sleep in. And then
how long is this?
Six or seven hours.
It's longer than you think. Oh. Like, it's, you could
7 to 8 hours.
Yeah.
Wow.
You get a full nap in there. You spend a night on this boat, basically.
They leave it 2 times during the day. One at noon and one at midnight.
The boat I went on, I think, is retired now. It retired many years ago.
Anyways, this one's called the ferry. So you get to North Sydney. It costs $30 per person and $100 per vehicle. So it ain't cheap.
Yeah.
Then you jump on this ferry, go 8 hours to some other port in Newfoundland.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, I'm in Newfoundland. Great.
No,
well, you want to go to St. John's, right?
Yeah.
Another 14 hours.
Yeah. Nine to 10 hour drive.
That's a big ass country we got.
You know?
And it's not even touching Labrador.
That's like a little island. Like, it's a 9 hour drive from the port you get dropped off at to get to St. John's, which is literally at the other side of this island.
There's so many other places
just
to go
like
to,
do a nice little.
But that would be another 45 days. Like,
there's tons of other places. Like, if you do Newfoundland properly, you got to hit up like.
I'm going to Gander. I'm going to St. John's. I'm not going all the way on this trip.
Why am I not going?
We looked at going.
Who's we?
don't worry about it. I looked at going, and it, I want to go to St. John's, Newfoundland. I want to go to Newfoundland. I've heard so many good, nothing but good things. But man, that's a long trip. One way, 20 hours plus 8 hours plus 10 hours or 9 hours.
I can get to Cambodia faster.
Like, you know what I mean? I'm in Miami, sitting on a beach, you know what I mean? Or I'm in St. John's.
You could be in Argentina faster. You could be, like I said, in Cambodia faster. You can be in Thailand faster.
Like, it's a long, long...
No, I want to do it again. So I mean,
I want to do it. We can plan it.
There's nothing to plan. It's just start driving, man.
No, there's a lot to plan.
That's rock and roll, man.
Yeah. Well, I've never been in
Newfoundland. There is etiquette here. You're not supposed to do what I'm doing.
Yeah, yeah.
I was in Newfoundland. Last time I was in Newfoundland was all when I was a kid. And I've never been to go to like a nice Newfie bar or like that type of environment. So I'd love to go back. And Vanessa's never been either, so I'd love to take her.
But even with... Oh, man, that's a brutal drive.
You have family there, right?
But the... yeah, I still have family there. The drive, though, when we went, we stopped on the way there. Let me finish my surface. On the way there...
You can grab it. It's not hot.
On the way there, we stopped in the first night in New Brunswick, stayed the night, and then went to Nova Scotia the next morning, got on the boat. So it's like a two-day... It's a two-day thing there and a two-day thing back. Not counting the St. John stuff. I'm saying to get into Corner Brook and stuff. On the way back, we stayed somewhere in Quebec in a hotel that had a roller coaster in it.
I'm not a fan of Quebec.
I know, but it's usually the most convenient place to stop on the way back.
Yeah.
Hot.
Yeah, it's tea. It's tea.
It's a little hot, yeah.
Holy hot.
But it wasn't as hot as I thought it would be, so.
But no, let's do it. I'm serious.
Yeah, we'll talk.
Okay. When were you aiming for?
Well, I think I'm going on a road trip with a friend in end of March.
You like mumble that? You said roid trips? Like, it'd be awesome if you're just going to do like a cycle of steroid right now.
No, end of March, I was looking to do a little road trip. Just before I start paternity, I still have a lot of vacation days to burn and all that good stuff.
Experimenting.
No, I'm not talking to you.
He's talking about my paternity leave not happening. I don't know why it wouldn't.
Maybe when you get back from Edmonton.
I'm going to Meaford instead. It's going to suck. Anyways, end of March.
This filter's not working very well.
It works fine.
I think you're imagining.
I have chunks in my mouth.
No.
Yeah.
The odd time that happens.
Yeah. It's fine. It's just tea leaves, and it's fine.
I didn't like that intro. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, let's move on to our standing segment of question of the week. Hit me up.
Mm-hmm.
I want to ask you guys, would you ever change your name?
But this question is directed towards Jesus. Like, I think it was
a good point.
It was defined for Jesus.
That is a good point. If someone's going to have wanted to or want to change their name, it would be you first, no?
Yeah, I guess so.
What's your middle name?
Rodrigo. So you guys answer the question first. Go ahead, you two discuss.
I wouldn't. I like the little bit of uniqueness in my name. There's not a plethora of Jamies going around.
Yeah, but the
I know a few.
Literally, I know one other. Not only Jamie Campbell. Like, not only is your name not unique, it's just literally one other guy I know. First and last.
So I wouldn't change it. I'm happy.
No, your name's good. I like your name too.
If I was going to be a boy or a girl, my name was going to be Jamie.
Really?
Yep.
Would it have been spelled differently if you were a girl?
I don't think so.
Because girls spell with like a Y,
sometimes
they'd
say...
Or put the I first.
A-I-M-E. I get that a lot when you order like Starbucks or something, they spell it like that. But no, I wouldn't change my name. I'm happy with it.
Yeah, that's a good name.
No, I wouldn't... Hold on, sorry.
You have no middle name. That's so weird.
That is weird.
Don't need it.
Did your mom just,
for a while,
did your mom just get
I didn't like that about you.
Did your mom ever give you a reason for that? Does your brother have a middle name?
Yeah. I gave it to him. It's Mark.
That's a not bad one.
He's all because in grade one, that was like my friend's name.
He should take that as his first name, Mark Mazzeo.
Yeah. Lucas Mark. I like my name. I like my name.
Shout out to mom.
To my mom?
Yeah, for giving you your name.
Yes, shout out. I like my name. I like my name without the H too. I think that just looks like the more natural way to spell Nicholas with no H.
Yeah.
And my mom was saying they had to decide when I was born, like, because I was born in Canada. So are they going to spell it with an H or no? And their worry was if they ever were to have moved back to Uruguay, if it was spelled with an H, they don't want all the kids to call me like Nicholas, because they would. And so they're like, all right, let's play it safe. Let's go no H. It's already how they're used to spelling the name anyways. And then if they ever were to have gone back to Uruguay, I won't be known as Nicholas. The alternative to my name, my mom said the other option was Rodrigo. Mm-hmm. Which, like, when you ever, do you have an alternative name? Like, do your parents ever tell you, like, what your other name?
Jay, I'm just Jay.
No.
I might have been Rodrigo, but.
Like, imagine this right now. Hey, I'm Rodrigo Mazzell. Welcome to another episode of.
I could.
That'd just be the regular.
You could see it? Yeah, you could see me as a Rodrigo right now?
Yeah, I can see it.
Yeah, yeah. It, like, I think it, like, literally turns Steph off.
Yeah.
Picture this as Rodrigo right now.
I knew a couple of Rodrigos in my life. They weren't the greatest.
No, they never are.
No.
So, shout out to Rodrigos out there. No, okay. and then if I was a girl, my mom said my name would have been Valentina.
That's cute.
I guess.
That's okay. I don't know about. It feels like, I guess your last name is Mazzeo. It's very Italian, but yeah. Actually, no. Valentina's.
Do you guys have like names picked out for your possible like second kids, or did you leave some? You know, if you had a boy instead of a girl.
We had a boy name going.
It was stolen. Stolen.
No, not really. I mean, sort of, but I mean, we didn't have much stock in our boy's name. It was literally like. I guess it, because we didn't know the gender. I guess if it comes out a boy, I guess this is its name. Like, whereas Malaya, we're like, okay, we're good to go.
It's cool that you don't have to lock that stuff in, though. Like, you can just let it slide for a while.
Yeah. 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 Mm-hmm. It was not official until you hit enter on the.
On that form.
Yeah.
I remember when Daniel was filling out Sebastian, I had to, like, look, how are you spelling that?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
100%, I think I know how to spell it, but, like, just make sure that you're spelling it how I think I'm spelling it. Because I don't want, I hate names. That try personally, like I'm very like picky
Jesus?
With names.
Jesus, he's so extra.
But like, if my name was Jesus, but you spelt it with an extra S.
Oh, J-A-Y-S-A-U-S.
Yeah,
Jesus.
I almost choked on my
thing. Or yeah, but it's exactly. But you're like, no, it's pronounced, you know, whatever. You know what I mean? That's what I
like.
It's
like. Spelled like Daryl, but it's pronounced Darrell or something.
Yeah, yeah,
but
yeah,
it's
yeah,
just
yeah.
Daryl.
Yeah. Yeah, he lives in Barry.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I don't like. So my name, I have a lot of stories. I'm not going to tell you all them all.
I think we've told it before.
Yeah, all of them.
No, yeah, how? Why I'm named Jesus?
Baby names? Let's not get it. We have a whole topic.
Why I'm named Jesus?
I don't know why.
I've heard 9 stories about you being called Jesus.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't think that's right too often. Anyways,
would you change your name?
Would I change your name? So. Quick story. Grade 9, I was going to.
That's the story you told.
That's the story I told? Well, there you go. Grade 9, I was going to change my name to Rodrigo. Teacher caught me off guard. I didn't get the chance. And I was... Yeah,
yeah. I you became Jesus forever.
Yeah, I became Jesus forever.
Yeah, house.
So I lost the opportunity.
What were you going to change? Rodrigo.
Yeah. Just gonna be Rod. So the teacher's going to call my name. I was going to be like, no, I go by my middle name. And she would have changed it on like the...
Yeah, and you would have forever been Rodrigo,
right? But I missed that window because everyone started laughing out loud when she said Jesus. Or
I wasn't Jesus. Changing your name legally, though. It's just when the teacher says, like, would you rather me call you this? And then he changes it on the attendance and, like, that's your name now.
So would I? I haven't, so I would not. It basically is the answer. Because you could. I could go and change my name. I could have done that since I was 18. Funny thing is, where I work, I deal with applicants a lot. I see a lot of name changes. People are changing their names a lot these days. And like some of them are just like spelling. I've seen a couple of spell like the Nicholas from like remove an H or stuff like that. Some of them like change their last names, some change just their first names. There's a lot. And there's a lot of good reasons. Like adopted kids now take their old parents, like their original parents' name, stuff like that. But Jesus was a tough name to grow up with. If you asked me this question when I was 12 years old, I think I would have said yes. Let's change it. To like Robert.
Steve.
Yeah. Steve or Robert Joe. Or James.
Joe. Go with Joe.
Or Joe. You know what I mean? Because at that point, having this name was so much work, I didn't want it. Now, I've used it to my advantage. Like, it's a conversation starter. I already know when now someone asks me my name, I know there's going to be a reaction. So now I'm prepared for it. When I was 12, people would ask me my name. I'd be like, hey, it's Jesus. And I just go on my way. And people are like, all right, stop. Come here, kid. What do you mean your name's Jesus? I'm like, I don't know. My name's Jesus.
I like my name. I think if I were to change it, it would go for like max manliness at that point. Because, you know, Jamie, Nicholas.
Lexton.
Yeah. Like, you know, like Maximus or something.
Or Bear.
Just Bear.
Bear.
Maximilian. My cousin named his son Leonidas.
Sounds like he has a disease.
Yeah, or it's all like the king of Sparta. That guy?
The itises.
With like the 20 pack? Yeah, the itis.
Anything that ends in itis is like an inflammatory disease.
We just call him Leo. So.
Yeah, I know. He just comes
Colonitis.
Leo.
Yeah.
The other Leo we know, the awesome Leo, right?
Yeah.
The only other Leo we know.
Groomsman of the year.
Not opposite. They're like the same.
But we just talked about Rodrigo. The,
yeah. So not the opposite. Like the partner in crime of Rodrigo. Okay. Is he Leonidas or is he just Leo?
I think he's Leonardo.
Yeah, he's Leonardo.
Yeah.
Leonardo Alvarado.
That was my only right. understanding of the name Leo would be the stem from Leonardo.
Ninja Turtles.
Yeah. But like it's also not the most uncommon name in the world. Like, you know, Leonardo, I'm sure if you meet a couple Italians.
You got a
DiCaprio.
Yeah, exactly. But Leonidas, so I was like, oh, okay. But he's still Leo.
That's okay. I like Leonidas is not a bad name. I can live with Leonidas.
Yeah. No, so if I were to change it, I would go something, I don't know. I always love that episode of The Simpsons where Homer picks his name off a blow dryer and he calls himself Max Power. That's a great name. I'd probably go for Max Power.
No, see, so my whole thing is if I were to change my name, I don't know if I would, but anymore, I wouldn't. I'm grown out of it. Like, I'm good. But a normal, straightforward name. Like, it sucks having to, like, explain your name, explain your pronunciation. You two don't know that, but it sucks. So that's what I would change.
I started to get salty with people. Like, if they ask you, is that your name? I'm like, yes. I've definitely not had that for 30 happens. Years in a row. Thank you.
Yeah. People are like, oh, that really? I'm like, no, I'm joking. And I walk away. So they're like, is he joking? Was he, you know what I mean? Or people are like, what's your name? Jesus. Oh, you mean Jesus. Bitch, did I say Jesus? Or did I say Jesus to you right now?
He's getting worked up.
Yeah.
Yeah,
he can't multitask either. So.
Are you carried away?
Push the button. Sorry. If I remember my first time working at Thermos.
I usually have the different thermos. Who's next? It was you?
Yeah.
So just fucking drink it.
Gracias.
Yeah, gracias. Are you guys like sold on your kids' names?
Yeah.
Like they're like, you know, like, because again, in the sometimes there's a little pressure. You got the 9 months. You're like, you need to have a name. Especially because you guys.
No, when we found that name, man, that was the name. And now he's Lincoln. He's Lincoln. That's Lincoln. I don't know. It's good. It sticks.
Yeah. Yeah. It sticks.
Yeah, I'm happy with Sebastian. That, I will go on record saying
I like that.
No, I do. I really do.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah, I would have been okay with just Leia, but then Malaya came and I really like Malaya now, but I still win because it's just Leia. For all intents and purposes, so I still got the princess.
Leia. I still call her Malaya.
Yeah,
so I'm one of those people that I like using full names. Occasionally, I'll call you Jay, but like rarely. I like saying Jamie. I like saying Vincent. William, I have to say William or his mom yells at me, like these type of things.
Yeah. Yeah. Cool. Anyways, guys, let's move on to a returning segment called Yahoo Answers.
This might need more sugar.
Go for it. I'm good with you.
Yeah. Say you want something and then blame it on me.
It's like when he orders like 50 tacos instead of yeah. Say, this is for Jamie. Anyways, let's move back to a returning segment called Yahoo Answers. This, as everybody knows, is a forum. People post questions, usually ridiculous, stupid questions. We like to react to these, answer them ourselves. Right. As a full mate. And get to the bottom of it. I thought you were going to say something.
It just bubbled like there was a turtle under there.
There might be.
It's hot water. Anyways, pull it up on the screen, Jamie, somewhere. This question is, I'm 16 and 5'8". Help.
So this is like... I wish we had the username.
This is a 16-year-old.
I wish we had the username to like say like, you know, little Jimmy here needs our help. He's clearly crying out for help. He's probably not 16 anymore.
Do you remember if it was a male or female asking the question?
I think it's a male. And
let's
go
with a male.
And I think further on in the question, he states he's 16 years old. He's 5'8".
And his family's all like 5'8".
His dad's like 5'7", and his mom's 5'4". He's worried that he's not going to grow any taller because all his friends are taller and currently make fun of him. So how can we help Jimmy 1-2-4?
Well, we're crew like 5'9", right? That's like our
5'9".
5'8". You know
5'9" in nice shoes.
You know we're a solid 5'7".
I'm 5'8" and a half.
I am 5'8".
You're not taller than I am.
What's 175 centimeters? That's what it says on my license.
That's what everyone's driver's license says.
You know how, what? Yeah. No one measured you. You wrote it down. So you guessed and wrote
it. When I went, the guy eyeballed me. 175 centimeters. I'm like, what is that? And centimeters, 16 years old. That made no sense.
He should work at the carnival if he's that good.
Yeah.
He was off by like 12 centimeters.
Yeah, you're not eight.
I'm 5'8" and a half.
I don't know about that half.
I don't know about that half.
I don't know about that half.
I just went a year ago because I started seeing a new doctor. He measures.
5'7" sounds so tiny.
We are, because we are though.
If you
go out, like, if you go out in public, we are. We are so tiny.
So I think we're all friends because we're the same height though, right? That's what happened.
Except for Frank and Nick by a half an inch.
Yeah. Well, we were friends before, so.
We're probably the same height at that point too. I just hit that growth spurt. Got that half inch.
How's life been treating you at 5'7"?
Ask yourself that, bro. I'm 5'8".
Looks good up here. I'm on a successful podcast drinking mate. You tell me, bro.
This is true.
No, I feel Jimmy124's pain here. That's his username. I feel his pain here because, you know, the thing is, he's got to count his stars lucky. 5'8", 5'9", I think is like officially the worldwide average.
Yeah.
Worldwide.
We're below.
16. What grade are you in 16?
10?
9, 11? 10.
Maybe 10, yeah.
Oh, you know, you could be in 11.
There was people towering over us at that age.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And for the rest of our lives.
So, Jimmy, 1, 2, 3, 4, you're shit out of luck.
Yeah, that's it.
The thing is, he's got to consider himself, okay, his dad's 5'7", his mom's 5'4". He won the genetic lottery there, and he's above them, and he's 16. He's got room to grow.
He may grow an inch. He got or half an inch, like Nicholas.
Yeah, yeah. And I don't know, he could have the odd family member. He could have height somewhere, and I'm no scientist, but I think genetics, there might be a little spark somewhere in there.
Yeah, he may, I'm working on it. He may benefit from an additional half inch at some point in his, like 2 years, because you grow, as a male, I think it's 18, you stop growing really. Like,
really? Oh, I don't know. I don't know what the age is for
18 or 19.
Stopping the growth.
Stopping
listen, Jimmy. I'll give you 5'10". I think that's your ceiling. Like, that's your
you're
max.
You're not getting there.
You'll hit.
At 16?
2 inches at 16, yeah, you're done.
Not
yeah.
at 16.
He's 16 years old, and he's 5'8". I say he tops out at 5'9".
You
and
think
he,
we were 5'8"? At 16?
No, we're still not 5'8".
No.
That's
yeah,
what
I was.
I think you've gotten a little shorter.
Yeah, if anything. But if anything, I reached this height by grade.
I don't remember being this tall in 16.
This tall.
I don't know, man. I feel like I still managed to grow some.
When did you grow some? What age did
I don't
you grow
know.
Some?
I didn't measure myself. I'm saying at 16.
But
I
you say you don't feel you didn't feel that tall then. When did you feel as tall as you are now?
I'd say my 20s somewhere. I'd say like this is it. This is it for me.
So in your 20s and then you hit it. You like you looked above. You looked at your kingdom. You're like this is. I am at my height.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
No, I think scientifically you stop growing like 18.
Vanessa and I keep having these moments where we look at Link and like, ah, he's not a baby anymore. He's a kid. Like that's
dude,
a
I
kid.
Have that with my kid. My kid's like 7 months.
Right, but we keep hitting these like milestones like this is next step. So she was holding the other day and he was like sprawling and just being retarded. But from his head to his toes, he's already like half the height or the length of Vanessa. Like, he's already big. Like it's crazy. Anyway, yeah, I don't talk about that anymore. You know what I wish we had when we were growing up in high school?
Mate?
It's nothing to do with our height. Sipping on mate in our spot. We never found the spot.
Oh, I was going to say. When you said the spot, I was like, I was never invited to the spot. Where
no,
are
like
you?
Your dad had that coffee time that was there, yeah. Right? My buddy, my brother's friends, they all have the spot. My cousin who just moved here from BC, they have this place called like The Hill or whatever. She just told me the other day. All these like people have the spot they go to. They call up your friends, hey, meet me at the place. And they go there. We never found that place. I thought when
I
they
did.
Opened the Tim Hortons by itself,
I can say that.
This table's moving away.
We're like probably not even on camera. We're like underneath. Where's your spot? I never came to your spot.
Vince's basement. Yeah, you did.
I guess,
that was the spot.
Guess,
like if there's any spot we've ever had, that
was
would
never,
be
it was
the
never
spot.
Like a public place though, right? Where you could just call you up and be like, I'm
to me, it was public. Like I walked in there.
Yeah, you just yeah. yeah. There was no door on that.
Yeah. House. They would change the locks weekly. I'd still just manage to get in.
Yeah. Yeah. What triggered through your head that you ended,
just
in,
I'm enjoying
this,
this
segment and then you
I'm enjoying the mate.
Don't you? It's communal. It's shared.
Yeah, I want to do mate more often.
I don't think anyone
it sounds like a drug
likes it their first time truly.
Well, it's not my first time.
And the first couple of sips were really
like
bitter.
It?
Sorry. Yeah. First couple of sips, oh no, we're really bad. Now it's getting smoother and nicer.
The sugar you added, I think, helps.
And it's better when there's not 4 minute pauses in between each mate.
Okay.
That's how we get him to stop talking so much. We give mate every week.
Clearly, it's not working.
We can bring mate back next week. I'm cool.
That'll just be the drink of forever.
The drink of forever.
If I told my mom, I was like rummaging through the cupboard. I'm like, Mom, I'm taking all your mate shit. So she's like, I'm not okay with it, but I'm happy you're drinking mate. So go for it.
As long as it's back here by 7 a.m. tomorrow morning.
No, she's more like she drinks it for like lunch. She'll have it with like lunch, yeah, but she'll
I've slept over for your mom doesn't get out of bed till at least 10, 11 o'clock.
Fact. And that's breakfast. So like noon is breakfast. It's all really confusing in my household.
That's crazy. Is your mom like a night owl?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. My mom will be easily up to 1 in the morning watching novellas.
I rolled out of his bed like 10:30 hungover. Yeah. Like 10:30 hungover, and just, I stumble over to the washroom, walk right past his mom in her nighty, and she's still in bed.
Yeah.
There's an agreement there. There's like a, she knows I'm there. I think once she looked at me and
Give you a wink.
I nodded. Howdy.
Why are you stopping? Like that should be. There should be no time for that. Like acknowledge.
That hallway's like long, too awkwardly long. It's short, but it's too much.
Anyways, I didn't know any of this. It is acknowledgement of you and my mom.
I feel like he goes, there's a bathroom downstairs, which he was closer to. He goes out of his way to go upstairs.
I sleep upstairs and his mom sleeps upstairs.
To like cop of the... Hey, Rosa. Is toy a key?
And my mom just like, she wants to play kind of like dumb. She's like...
Hola.
Oh man, your mom just seduced the shit out of Kate. That's mine. Oh, that's mine. You
no, it's his.
That's he just finished.
No, I didn't. You just handed it to him.
Nah, I feel
rewind.
Like you, I feel like you just had the last.
I one. Just drank, and I drank after you.
Done. See, that's how it should actually be, though. And then just get to the
this. This month is really tired.
It's too hot to do that.
No, it's not. All right, Jimmy, 1, 2, 4.
Your shit, too bad.
Yeah.
I think the moral story is you'll be fine. You're fine.
They'll life
be,
moves oh, on.
Forever and ever. Here's the, I'm talking to you,
for
Jimmy.
Some people, it
doesn't. Give him the one.
Zoom in on here. Jimmy, for the rest of your life, women will want men taller than you. But they'll settle. They'll settle for 5'8".
Play the long con.
They'll even settle for 5'7" sometimes. Just go for it, okay? You'll always want to be a little taller. It's not gonna happen.
Eat your vegetables, work out a little bit more.
You got a little hope. There's hope. We know we're all crossing
vitamins.
Our fingers for you.
We did the math.
Hopefully you get another inch.
I think there's some drugs out there. They stick in you. You go right up there.
Mate time.
You don't need a coaster, dude. You don't need a coaster.
Though apparently he does. All right. Yahoo Answers solved. Anyways, let's move on to the final segment of the week. It's a new one. Good jingle. Anyways, it's Family Feud. We're going to play a little game here. We're just slapping.
It's like
the
a
table.
New segment. It's like the oldest segment.
Can we call it Friendly Feud?
Yeah, we can't copyright.
Oh, that's right. Friendly Feud between the dads and the six.
Or Dad Feud. Dad Feud.
Dad Feud. All right.
Ryan, doesn't have.
It'd be funny if every time he changes the logo. Like,
yeah, Jamie. People are loving the post-edit production.
People are loving the production values here.
Yeah.
I think all I do is like spend my time at home and work on this podcast.
Yeah.
As opposed to what else? Like, what else do you got going?
What else? Projects.
I will be the moderator host.
Okay.
As I do that.
Don't let him cheat off your phone.
Okay. So, it's going to work the same way Family Feud is. I'm going to read a question. It's going to have obviously multiple choice answers that are correct. In order to start answering, you guys have to buzz in. I'm just going to accept a slap on the table.
You gotta have like one arm behind your back, like Family Feud,
or one hand on the
mat,
and then
one touching your chest, and then one eye closed.
I'm gonna let you guys figure that out because I do not give
this.
A shit.
When we slap this,
hands on the table.
Yeah, that's what they do. They put it on like a
no, because you have to buzz. We can't buzz anything. So
buzz that.
Put you buzz with your left hand, whatever hand you buzz, it has to touch in the back of your chair. That's the easiest way.
No, table's good.
No, because then you just do this. So this way you have to like all the way to the front.
No, you slap this. And then whoever's hands on the bottom won.
Okay, well, make sure it's closer to me.
Okay, equal so, arm length.
How do you play this game? So you buzz in and you start giving me some answers.
Yeah, and if I get one right, I get to guess again. And then
got it.
We'll figure
out. We'll just say whoever guesses the most of them wins.
Okay, so I'll have a score sheet going here.
Score the answer value. That's how much points I get.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Question one on dad, family, friend.
No, on the corn. Like, yeah.
Need a ruler.
Okay. First question. Name a good occupation if you're good at lying.
Damn it.
I'll give it to Jesus.
Lawyer.
Yes.
That was my number answer. One,
42 puntos.
Is that the number one answer?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
How many more answers are there?
Five.
Ooh.
Ooh, I'm right, out.
You get to go again.
My second answer to if I am good at lying, I would be a, I don't know, I'm going to say comedian.
Shit.
What?
That's
you
on there.
You cheated.
No, I did. Scout's honor.
So that's the fourth best answer. So I just give him the points, right? It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
You just keep going. Okay.
Yeah.
Until he misses. Ah, got it. 4 points.
If I was good at lying, I would be a used car salesman. Car salesman.
I'll give it to you. I'll give it to you. There's sales.
He's cleaning up.
There's sales. Yeah, sales is the number two answer at 19 points.
Killing.
I'm right now.
Keep going. You're
I literally
good. Good.
Come up with the answer as I say, if I was good at lying, I would be a...
I'm going to give you a 3-second timer now.
Count it out for me.
3, 2, 1.
A pharmacist.
He's dying. He's on
Is it on there?
No.
Is it on there? I'll go with... So how Family Feud works...
You get to steal. And then
if I get one, I get one guess and I steal all his points.
Oh, shit.
That's how Family Feud works.
Right. I think so. That's cool.
I don't know how to swap these points over.
Arrows.
Okay.
I'm going to go with a police officer.
Shit. That shouldn't be on there.
No.
Damn. So I win. So
you
I get, all,
you
I,
get all those points.
I get all the points.
Yeah. Easy.
End of round.
Round
what was
one.
The rest of the answers?
Politician.
Oh.
That's a Family Feud
that's
reaction.
They always do, yeah.
I mean, the Friendly Feud.
You said comedian. Yeah, that was good. That was on there.
Yeah.
Private Eye.
I wouldn't have guessed that.
I wouldn't have guessed them to lie. Psychic.
Ooh.
Those are motherfucking liars.
Go on.
And then, see, when it pops up on the thing, the Family Feud thing too, everyone goes, psychic.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what. All right.
That's what she said.
Question two.
Put your hand back.
Prepped?
By your stand.
Do you want to measure the difference between my stand and your stand to this?
Nope.
I'm doing it.
Two pens.
You're close.
You're good.
That was the worst measuring I've ever seen.
All right. Question two. Name a place where it's important for children to sit still. I'll give it to Jamie.
School. Good answer.
That's number three.
Number three.
9 points. Keep going.
One of you.
I think it's me.
Where we want them to sit still. In the car.
And
oh, I got it. Ready?
You gotta steal it.
Church.
Motherfucking number one.
Number one.
53 points.
I didn't think I'd be good at this.
Like, I'm not gonna get any.
Church boy over there.
What happens? He wins? He steals your point?
Yeah.
Just steal your point.
Give him all my points. The last round's worth triple the points.
Yeah.
No. This is not a last round because this is going good. I like this.
Quadruple the points.
You're not prepared.
I'm prepared.
He is always prepared.
Okay, this one. This one.
Pharmacist.
This one. We're pharmacists. This one because we're dads.
Can you do this with alcohol?
No.
You mean drink
tea?
Bailey's in here?
That, like, you know you're an alcoholic. When you drink tea in the morning, like instead of water.
No, this could be a nighttime.
You just boil some Bailey's.
You do it with milk. Milk's
I slurped
a,
there. I'm
a
sorry,
suggestive.
Guys. I slurped there a little
it's
bit.
It's all right. Last slide.
Etiquette.
This one, because we're dads and because none of you have daughters, I think this will be good.
None of you. Oh, no, we don't have daughters.
Premature.
Name something that costs more money if you have a daughter instead of a son.
He buzzed before you finished talking.
You don't have to. You can answer anytime.
Yeah, family dad friend feud, you can do that. Jesus.
Also, normal family feud. Can you repeat the question?
Name something.
I also didn't hear the question.
Name something that costs more money if you have a daughter instead of a son.
Shoes.
I'll give it to you because I don't give a shit.
You're giving him all this shit.
Clothing.
All right. Sure. Yeah. That's what I meant.
37 points.
What number was that?
That was the second of two answers.
I know the other one.
What is it?
It's not my turn.
So hold on, let me see. Hair product.
And wedding.
Correct.
Oh man, I'm not thinking that far out. That's just crazy.
42 points.
Yeah, am I winning?
No, how could you be winning?
Zero winnings. Okay. Okay, Jamie's so far behind going into the last round.
Oh, four rounds is such a weird number.
Okay, five.
We're over. So much mate in my throat.
Okay.
Mateo. Okay. Mateo's a good name.
You guys aren't ready for buzzing.
I'm ready.
Name an animal we eat that would never eat us. Ooh, I'm going to give that to Jamie.
Cow.
That is number one. Good, correct.
How many answers 58. Are there?
58. You've gotten... This is your points right now.
That's I can't read that.
It's a hundo.
My life depends on this.
Jesus has more numbers.
How many answers are there?
Total six. You already got one, so...
Five left.
Okay, can you repeat the question?
No.
How
many animals can you eat now?
That won't eat you. Chicken.
Number two. This one might have set him up for a big comeback here.
Pigs.
No, that is incorrect.
Pigs would eat you.
Pigs would eat the shit out of you.
Pigs are number three.
I thought about the other day. What happened to that pig that Danny's sister had? Is that still kicking around? Or is it...
We don't talk.
I don't think we talk about that.
No, I don't know.
I'm not up to date.
I was just joking.
I think she still has it.
So there's still three more answers?
Here's one or two answers. Yeah, she still has it and it's great, or she doesn't have it.
So anymore. I've killed the top three. There's still three more?
Before we delve into that, because now I have to know. For the record, you own a pet pig. You eat it when it dies, right? Like, you don't eat your dog.
I don't think so.
Yeah, you eat it. I would.
You eat it.
Like, you're asking me? Because yeah, I would.
Okay. Would they eat it?
No.
Family Feud question. Pig dies. Number one. Okay, go ahead.
Turkey.
Jesus, for the steal.
Salmon.
No.
Salmon.
What happens now?
I win. I get all my points.
What do you mean? What food you eat, they would never eat you? Salmon wouldn't eat me.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
It's an animal.
You're not wrong.
You said fish.
Is fish the answer? Like, is fish?
Fish is an animal. I'll give you that. But you're not wrong, but you're also not right.
Okay, what are the last three then?
Rabbit.
Mm.
Deer.
These are all game.
Sheep. I don't think sheep's game.
People eat that stuff, but also fish should be on there.
So
specifically salmon.
No, we're doing fifth round because you said four.
Okay, yeah, but
stupid.
What's the score?
I don't know.
We're tied.
One thing each.
Two things each.
All right, I didn't prepare five. But
what are you doing this weekend?
Yeah, you guys fill the background notes.
I'm working.
That's right. Can you stop that?
No, I went out last weekend.
It's true, I was there.
Did you have fun last weekend?
Seemed it.
I had fun.
There's a dad's in the sixth spotting.
I like the surprise of the surprise guest you brought to the party Saturday.
A cousin? Oh, you know what I missed out on?
Yeah, and a high cousin from Vancouver.
Oh, Tony.
Tony's good.
At midnight, they brought pizza.
Like pizza?
The club buys pizza for people, for everyone. Like literally we're playing shuffleboard and someone plopped a pizza down our table.
But what brand?
It was like white boxes. But it was from a pizzeria. It was awesome. It was like the coolest thing ever.
Was it unlimited? I had that once at a club.
Two slices.
There was a club one time we went where they had like at midnight or whatever, they had food. Not even at midnight.
That was Sea Lounge when we went last time and we threw the cake in our faces. Wasn't that the time?
No.
You're staring at me so blankly.
No, that time we went there was like a private party.
We stole the cake.
And we stole their food. Okay. No, but there was another club that like, there was a thing like at 1 in the morning they came out with like little like appetizers type thing.
They brought sandwiches. It was sandwiches.
And sandwiches.
Yeah.
All right, let's rock and roll. Final question. Whoever wins, we'll figure this out. Whatever. This website kind of blows. According to single men.
I'm not that.
That's right. This is why it's harder. What is the one thing you might want to know when you meet a woman?
A wombat.
A woman.
Is it wombat or woman?
The spelling here is meet a woman, but do not have the nerve to ask. What is one thing you might want to know when you meet a woman, but do not have the nerve to ask? Jamie got it. No, okay. Go ahead, Jesus.
How many men you slept with?
Why'd you both answer?
No, I asked you how many answers there are.
Oh, there's three.
And his wasn't on it?
That's no. That's the thing. I know.
How much D is that? Very word the same.
Very
word. How much D?
I would give you as the fourth answer. I would give you that one.
So I just got to get one. Otherwise, we just tie and this whole game is useless. I'm going to go with how much money she makes.
Fuck you. No.
Really?
No.
I don't want to know like what kind of makeup she's wearing.
What is one thing might...
Oh, does she or does she not want to have kids?
Yes.
There you go.
Too bad the game's over and we tied.
Is she age? Or is she age? What's her age?
Is she Asian?
Is she Asian?
Oh, the age.
Is that a question?
I had to ask mine. and single. What is one
the
thing
age
you
one
might
is
want
odd.
To
the
know
age
when
one we should
meet
have
a
got.
Woman.
When you,
okay,
you meet
so
one.
It's not you go on a date. You meet a woman.
You meet a random person.
And she's slightly attractive, but you might want to know, but you shouldn't probably ask, hey, are you single? Right?
Okay, start off with that. What's the next question?
Age.
Oh, yeah. Well, how old are you? Okay.
And does she have kids?
Yeah, I guess I need to know these things, too.
You need to know these things, but you don't want to ask these things when you just meet a woman. But
right.
You're single.
But also, how much D?
How much
so
D?
I think this question is flawed because it should have clarified that it wasn't on a date. I think that changes things.
I think it clarified it by not saying it.
The omission of it is the confirmation.
That's good, Mate. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been another episode of DIT6 Podcast. Episode number 16. Thank you for all your support. Thanks for sticking with us as we figure out this show. I think that was a little weird there for the last 10 minutes. Leave that alone. Ladies and gentlemen, hit that like, share, subscribe button. Leave a comment down below if you enjoyed this.